Check one, check one. Testing 1 2 1 2. Check 1 2 1 2. Say something, Sue. Let me know if you can hear me or not. You get any other guess now? Checking, tell me if the microphone, if you can hear me talking in the microphone here. This is the Sony. So I want to make sure the piece microphone working. Thank you.
Thank you. I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. Please stand. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into this world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms.
Good evening. First of all, I want to take this opportunity to extend condolences to the family and to the friends and wider community of our deceased sister. However, we are aware that we are still under COVID-19 protocol restrictions, and therefore we have a slight problem. The maximum number in which we have been allowed at this church to take for any church service or event is 58 persons. We are way above 58 persons. Unfortunately, in keeping with the laws of Barbados and with the laws of the COVID-19 as set out by the COVID-19 unit, I have to ask some persons to step outside of the church. We must have 58 persons in here and no more. The very close family remains not a problem. But as long as you're not part of that group, I have to abide by the laws of this land. We're still counting more than 58. parish warden. Are you satisfied?
We stand and sing the hymn through all the changing scenes of life.
Thank you. please be seated for the eulogy. Eulogy by Anisha Sober. Let us pray. Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant Vadney Odessa, and we pray that having opened to her the gates of larger life, you will receive her more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, she may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ onward, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The first scripture reading by Patricia Arthur.
A reading from the Word of God written in the book of Joel, chapter 19, beginning at the 21st verse. Have pity on me, have pity on me, O you my friends, for the hand of God has touched me. Why do you, like God, pursue me, never satisfied with my flesh? Oh, that my words were written down, oh, that they were inscribed in a book, oh, that with an iron pen and with lead they were engraved on a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been thus destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me. Here ends the Bible reading.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 23.
Thank you. Good afternoon. This afternoon, we're gathered here to celebrate and reflect on the life of Vadney Odessa Sealy. Vadney was a former employee of the Ministry of Transport and Works, the Bagatelle Depot. Vadney was born on January 7, 1964, to Evansley Bradshaw and Onita Sealy. Loving mother of Omar, Deidre, Tanya, and Shane, who brought her 7 grandchildren. Vadney was a spokesperson for the entire family, and if you never saw her face, you knew her voice. Absolutely no one could mess with the Sealy once Vadney was here. This attitude was further extended to her friends, who she treated as family. However, although she would stand up for you, she would definitely tell you when you were wrong. She gave the best advice, never an overly emotional person, but she made sure to get over her point, even if she added a few words to season up her sentences. And we know exactly how that went. Who didn't laugh or even smile in her presence? There was never a dull moment with her around. It is indeed ironic that I stand here with her not next to me, but she's laying before me. Vadney was my funeral partner. It would usually be her head and I. Vadney knew exactly how to ease the mood of any sad occasion. She used to crack a few jokes here and there. This is, of course, until Heather and I would look around and realize that she disappeared with Pearlene, and all we could do is laugh. One Sunday, Vadney called and asked if Evan was finished cooking. I told her I cook. She said, "What? I never hear about you yet." And I told her how much of a top chef I was, and she said she would try it. Minutes later, I called to hear her review, and she said that it was nice. Vadney shed her light beyond Barbados. She loved to travel, and visiting her daughter Tanya and grandson Kalijah was her favorite trip. Abroad, she liked to ride on the train, shop of course, and try new cuisines. She absolutely loved Chinese buffets, and she would reminisce on her time spent upon her return home. It was never all play with Vadney. Prior to her service at MTW, she worked diligently with her mother in the field of agriculture. She later became employed to do housekeeping, and then in 1997, a general worker. Her persistence and hard work are traits she derived from her mother, Onita. Vadney had an inseparable relationship with her mother. Onita would always say, "Vadney went all the boat with me, and if I call she know, she will come." She would always accompany her mother to doctor visits, and she was definitely her mother's personal chef. This inseparable nature could also be seen in relationships she had with her siblings, especially her sister Heather. Her close friends, Tracy, Glassberg, Pearlene, and Andrea, just to name a few. Her daughter-in-law, Suzette, and we could take off the in-law because she treated Suzette as though that was her daughter. She cared for her like such. Her grandchildren, Renicia, Jaheen, Jamali, Jade, Zane, Shanae, and Kalijah, who could do no wrong in her eyes because of the love she had for them. In the same breath, however, when it came to sharing lakes, it wasn't just a one person. Everybody had to get leave. And if Vadney here had a call with somebody from home, she leaving home and going across there and share lakes and then ask questions. She always made sure to show a level of discipline, and this went for all of her children, even when they were younger. Her children, nieces, and nephews could agree with me when I say that her no never meant no. Even though she may not be pleased with the situation, she would always show up. If you had one call and you were in trouble, call Vadney. Vadney was one in a million, and no one had a similar personality. Absolutely no one could do it like she did or say it like she said. Gramps Morgan puts it well. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you're If you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way. There is a place for people like you. My dear cousin, my friend, you have but only left us in the flesh. You will forever be in our hearts.
Second Bible reading by Amy Herbert.
A reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, beginning at the first verse. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. There will be his people, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every fear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." And the one who was sitting on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children, the word of the Lord."
That's beautiful. The hymn 497, Blessed Assurance. through his evil. Words from the Paul's letter to the Roman Church, chapter 8, verse 35. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? From the moment we enter into this world as human beings, we are exposed to the world around us. And as a result, we grow and we become familiar with things, we become familiar with people in our environment and in our immediate communities. And once we have grown to love, we have grown to appreciate all of these things, over time we foster deep bonds and we foster deep relationships, especially after the very first real experience. Circumstances can develop which can carry the responsibility of keeping us apart from the physical and the emotional comfort and happiness we experience with all that we love. When we consider, for example, a young mother who struggles particularly with the reality of having to go back to work soon after the birth of her child, she feels the hurt and she feels the guilt at not being there for her child during those daytime hours especially. And she feels the child's discomfort, not hearing her voice, not smelling her body, or feeling her warm or familiar presence near. When we consider a couple who's courting, they go through the court day throes of the sweet sorrow of parting every evening. And sometimes small misunderstandings can be the cause of a long-term separation among family members and among friends. And these are just a few of the mere examples of the inexhaustible amount of causes which affect or which cause separation. But perhaps for the human being, for the Christian, the most terrifying and the most dreaded cause for separation is that of death. And yes, with any type of separation comes unhappiness, comes fears, real or imaginary, comes a certain level of depression and even withdrawal. And finally, we reach that point of acceptance. But death creates the atmosphere which others perhaps do not create, at least not to that extent or to that magnitude. And that is the feeling of finality. It is finished. And that never again there will be the contact of any kind with those whom we find ourselves separated from. And so Paul, addressing the church at that time, reinforced to them that they were not exempted or immune to the challenges of separation which life brings with it. They too could expect to fall sick, to be weak, to get old, to die, just like anybody else. And however, the difficulties of life were not necessarily the obstacles for God's children. These could easily be turned into stepping stones towards experiencing God's greater grace and God's glory. Paul further responded to their concerns by asking them a few questions. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress, persecution, famine, nakedness, perils or death? And so he scoffed at the mere thought of any of these being able to carry any sway. As for the one who believes in the power of Christ has within him or her the ability to conquer these. And so these words taken from Paul's letter to the church, the Roman church, can be seen to us as a hymn of assurance, one which the Christian can write upon the heart and sang confidently whenever the urgency to do so arises. A hymn that says clearly that if we are loved by Christ, we can face situations boldly and not alone. For this love for us is in fact that nothing can ever alter. His love, God's love for each and every one of us, will help us move through these challenging times. And so to the family of our departed sister, this period of separation will not be easy. You will have questions. You might even have questions for God. This period will bring tears to your eyes, and sometimes at the most inopportune time. It will take a little while for you to come to grips with the loss which you are experiencing today. But putting your trust in Christ, not allowing yourself to be blocked by the hindrances of the world, would go a long way in helping you to emerge from this challenge and to be a stronger person in the end. This community of faith shares your sorrow with you. This community of faith, we have a responsibility to you. That is to pray with you and for you and support you whenever the need arises. To stand with you and to walk with you during these most challenging times. And please understand you're not alone. Because as Paul reminded the church back then, reminds us today, those words are still important to us today. Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. Your being here this afternoon is an indication that we all care. We are here because we wish to show our support and to assure this grieving family that we will call their names in prayer, asking God to bring them his peace and his comfort. And so to the family of Vadney, I take this opportunity once again, on behalf of the church here at St. Thomas, the wider church community, to extend our deepest condolences to you at this time. We pray that God will continue to go with you, strengthen you, and guide you through these challenging days. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand as we recite the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. The hymn, I serve a risen Savior. by Diana Prince and Vinicius C.
Good evening.
I'm going to take the only thing. still love, still miss our very dear. We miss you, brother. We will forever love you. My dear goes away that I don't think of you. The holidays will not be the same. And it's Sunday from November 2021 before I get another angel. I don't want to finish them, but I don't ever want to stop. I'm going to come and see you someday at your prom. I will never forget all that you have done for me to be where I am today. Thank you for loving and believing in me. Just the other day you told me that you got me and you would come home soon. That I know as we prayed that you would help get past this and recover. But God had other plans. You will always have a special place in my heart.
I'll see you again. I love you, Parish. I feel right now. I'm telling you, my given the pending weather, we have decided that we will have the committal of the deceased here in the church, and after the prayers we will then proceed to the burial site. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister, Vadney, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. In sure and certain hope of a resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Vadney, and we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this, our sister, and we ourselves, may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not soaring as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance to your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord. May her soul and the souls of the faithful departed through the tender mercies of God rest in peace. Amen.
righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness under the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you. Into paradise may the angels lead you, that your coming may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem."
coming back. I'm not going nowhere.
The flowers coming, the main flowers coming in now. Yes, he comes soon. Hello. Just keep going. I think every time they're blocking the camera. People are on Zoom. I see.
Come on.
Go and
put it down. You
who?
No, it's
not you. Who? They can be crossing here now and then, so go change the shot. You get me? These are the tiny ones. Help, yeah. Carry them in. Help them in. Put it there, she put it there. Good afternoon, too. Watch the balloons and the stone. Thank you. Excuse me.